"What is this?" he asked. "A guilder," the man said. "I couldn't tell," Fritz said, "but it's yours." The man took the banknote and put it in his pocket. "At least that is taken care of," Fritz said, bumping into the closed door. "I have an urgent request. One would do well to warn me when our vehicle reaches Danis Square." He tried to whistle, but no sound came out. "This is it," said a lady in a green hat. "Thank you very much," Fritz said. "Your kindness is exemplary." A man gave him a hand as he climbed down. He crossed the tracks and walked towards a group of three policemen. "Good evening, gentlemen," he said. "I hope you are doing well. The fact of the matter is that I have had a few beverages, but not quite too much, which means you have no reason to detain me. I have had a few, but not quite too much. How delightful." "Go on with you," one of the policemen said. "Move along and get some sleep." "Wise counsel," said Fritz. "I thank you sincerely." He walked up to a telephone kiosk and made moves to pass water against it. "You can't do that," the same policeman said. "There is a urinal over yonder." He pushed him away. "Of course," said Fritz. "You're quite right. Highly incorrect what I was doing. I hope you will accept my heartfelt apologies." He turned the corner down a broad street, leaned for a few moments against a shop window, and addressed a man who was passing by with a lady in one arm and holding a bicycle by the handlebars. "Excuse me for bothering you," he said, "but do you happen to know the way to Schilderskad? As long as I'm headed in that direction, it is a matter of finding the right way. Once I know that, it will all go automatically. I have had just a bit too much. It is wrong, but there is nothing to do about it now.